Congressman's wife, Doty, was talking with our Amanda Lewis today inside the couple's home near Lamoni. And Amanda joins us now with an exclusive look at where it all happened and a little bit of how. Amanda.
Kevin, Doty was kind enough to invite us inside for an amazing story about her family's confrontation with the masked gunman.
It's a terribly hot day to have to do this.
75-year-old Doty Boswell calls the couple's rural home near Lamoni her own personal Shangri-La. But the peacefulness was rudely interrupted Saturday night when a masked gunman came in through the front door and attacked her daughter.
He went in like this, and he grabbed Cindy by the neck with the gun at her neck.
Doty says her daughter reacted almost immediately, and the struggle took her and the gunman down the stairs.
And she's a fighter. She's a spunky. She fought him back, and he grabbed her by the throat to choke her. And then he had the gun to her head.
Doty says the gun turned out to be a BB gun, but at the time it looked real.
Cindy's screaming. Leonard comes running. First he goes to the bedroom and he comes running in here. He runs down there and the three of them scuffle. And I come in here and I lean over that and I said, "What are you doing here? What's going on?" And he comes running up to me and he puts the gun on my neck. What made me do it? I don't know. I would never have dreamed I'd do it. And I took my left hand and I rubbed his cheek and I said, "You don't need to do this. You really don't need to do this."
Doty says at that point, her 22-year-old grandson appeared with a shotgun and the man ran out the door.
Mitchell went out the back and shot twice up in the air. If he wanted to, he could have killed him, but he knew better.
Doty says the man fled into the field to a car he had parked nearby, but not before dropping the gun and a bag. Clues that could help lead police and the FBI to the man who interrupted Doty's peace and quiet. She says despite the close encounter, she still feels at home in her house of 37 years.
That's what I call it, my little Shangri-La.
Well, the couple owns two Rottweilers, but both dogs happened to be kenneled the night the man broke in, Kevin.
She seems incredibly calm reliving all of this with you.
She said she felt incredibly calm during the whole thing. She said her faith in God just gave her this kind of strength and calmness to get through the whole thing.
Indeed she did. Well, thank you very much. Yeah, really. Thanks, Amanda.